It's almost become trite now in the market that there's a lot of uncertainty. And I hear from our clients, where are things going to go? What should we do? And I'll tell you, it's uncertain for a reason, because there are a lot of new things that are going on. We have a new administration where the expectation is that this is going to be a substantial change from current policy, but a much greater change from the policies that we would have had a different administration won the election. That's a very wide gap. And most of those policy changes are in the nature of stimulus. The gap is more stimulative than what we would have had. Less regulation instead of more regulation, lower taxes instead of higher taxes, a bigger commitment to spend on infrastructure, maybe even spend on military. All of those have the effect of being stimulative. And that provides kind of a boost to the expectations for GDP and optimism. And I'd say another thing, it comes in connection with a macro environment that was otherwise changing, evolving in that direction anyway. So for example, rates are probably going to go higher. That's kind of baked in, and that will happen. That adjustment has to be made. Another thing, and I'm talking here about the US, we're also seeing performance divergence in terms of economy, and therefore there'll have to be some policy adjustments in terms of rates. So while we feel that rates are going to trend upward here, they may not happen in the same pace in other countries where they're off a different part of their cycle. Because of that divergence, you'll get differences in interest rates that could very well lead to differences in currency rates. We've already seen the dollar strengthen, and then the dollar has come off that trend a bit, and now it may come back onto that trend if that gets reestablished as the core base case scenario of the U.S. getting stronger and outperforming other economies around the world. It's a vanity always at any given moment to think, my goodness, we have challenges of a dimension we've never seen before. The world is more uncertain. It's always uncertain when you're living in it, and it always seems so simple and sure when you're looking back at it. I'm sure from the perspective of a year from now, we'll look back at whatever emerges now and saying, of course, how could it have been otherwise? And so the change in the market today is from a cycle where we were of very low economic activity, consequently very low interest rates, and a very, very high level of maybe call it pessimism about where we go. And it feels like we're changing one into which it's going to get growthier, more growth out there, more opportunity, and one in which we're getting a bit more optimistic. So I'd say change in general creates opportunity, but change from a pessimistic state of mind to one of more optimism is the better of the two possibilities.